Hey guys, Mae here, and today I'm doing a video that was requested by you guys. Today I'm doing a video about how I choose my biases in K-pop and kind of like the process that I go through. Not that it's like really a process, and I feel like sometimes I don't need to make a video like this, like when it's been on my list of videos to make for a little bit, and I was kind of like, I don't know if I need to make a video about that, but you guys were asking me in my live the other day how I choose my biases, so I was like, I guess people are like actually curious about how I do it. So yeah, let's just go ahead and get started. First of all, I feel like I tend to gravitate towards like a certain type of member, you know what I mean? So I feel like I tend to gravitate more towards dancers in groups. This doesn't apply to every single one of my biases. I have exceptions, of course, but I feel like for the most part, I go towards dancers. I don't know why. I would say second, I go towards main vocalists. That's just, that would be like my second thing, but again, not true because some of my biases are sub vocalists, some of my biases are rappers. Like, I feel like it's pretty much across the board, but for the most part, I go for dancers and main vocalists. When I first get into a group or somebody says, you need to stand so and so, I will go through and watch the music video, and if I like the music, then I will be like, okay, I should stay in this group, let me choose a favorite member. And for the most part, it'll usually be that member that stands out to me. Either I really like their part in the song, or I really just like their face. Like, I don't know how it is, and it's not like I always choose the member that's like, I have very few biases that are considered the visual of their group, but it's just something about like their face that I'll be like, I choose you. Usually that's how I end up gravitating towards main vocalists, is because if I really like their part in the song, I'll be like, ooh, this part in the song is really good. Who's the member who sings that? And for the majority of my groups, I like to watch variety stuff too. So I'll choose that member. They'll be like my tentative bias, I'll say. And then I will go through and try to watch some sort of variety. So at least like 20, 30 minutes of a variety show if that's all I watch. If all I watch is one episode of Weekly Idol with, say, let's take 17 for an example. Though 17 is kind of a different story. If I go through and I say, this is my bias, Seungchul, S-Coups is my bias, let me go see what he's like variety-wise. Because another thing I really look for is people who are very, I almost said very good at variety, but now that I'm thinking about it, I feel like a lot of my biases are really bad at variety. Yeah, so I guess I bias people who are really bad at variety. But you know what? I think I bias a lot of those members who will just stand in the corner and laugh during variety shows. Yeah, that sounds pretty accurate. I'm thinking about like Donghae, Woohyun and Sungyul, Wano. Woohyun usually has some like sassy remarks to say. Same with Sungyul. They're all pretty sassy, all my biases. S-Coups will just stand in the corner and laugh. Yeah, like a lot of my Hyuk will stand in the corner and laugh. So I feel like it's not like the member who's like the focus of the variety shows, you know what I mean? Like my biases are rarely the focus of variety shows. So I will try to watch something variety shows. This helps me learn the personalities of the members a little bit more. And I feel like Weekly Idol, even though Weekly Idol is not really a thing anymore, I mean it is, but it's not a thing like it used to be. Like to see something from them. A lot of the groups that I stan from this whole generation of Produce 101, elimination programs, yada yada yada. A lot of groups have pre-debut shows now, so if I'm interested in a group pre-debut, I'll watch their pre-debut show and I'll choose a bias that way. It's how I chose my bias in Uptension and Golden Child. I chose my biases kind of from that. Golden Child, again, is a different story because I've been following those trainees for a long time and I've known Sungyun and Jungjoon for a long time, like years. I feel like if you just choose a bias just from watching the music video, that's fine, but sometimes I feel like when I do that, I end up changing my bias later on. So I feel like if I watch a music video, a couple music videos, learn all the members' names, it also helps learn the members' names by watching variety for me, because they're just like constantly either showing the members' names in the corner, or which is like a constant like, this face is this person, this face is this person. I feel like JYP, like JYP boy groups at least, I have a type. I've noticed this. So Junkae, when 2PM, the beginning of 2PM's career, Junkae barely had any lines. He had like ad libs, And then when GOT7 debuted, my bias in GOT7 is Youngjae, and during Girls, 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 he had like ad libs, and I was like, that's like, it still blows my mind that I chose both of them as my bias, like when I watched the music video, and then I watched Variety, and I was like, oh my gosh, like, they are my biases. And for Stray Kids, it doesn't really work that way because Woojin does have quite a bit of parts in their songs, but I feel like it's still less than some of the members. So there's a couple of groups that I've changed biases in. UKISS I changed biases in like a long time ago. My K-pop age is gonna show. Alexander, when he was in the group, he was my bias, and then he left, so Suhyun became my bias. That was super weird. Also, EXO, I've changed, not Schumann. And when EXO was XOK and XOM, Schumann was my XOM bias, and Baekhyun was my XOK bias, and then Chanyeol became my XOK bias. Maybe it went back to, maybe it was Dio for a little, I don't know, like, I've changed my XOK bias so many times, and like, so I kind of, when EXO dropped XOK and XOM, I kind of dropped having another bias in EXO. Boyfriend, my bias used to be Youngmin, and now it's Jungmin, which doesn't sound that different, but like it is, there's different people. BTS, my bias was Jungkook for a minute, and then Jin was like, that's a funny story. Super Junior, my bias was Heechul before I watched Variety, funny enough, because he was the first member I learned when watching Super Junior music videos, and then I watched Variety and I was like, but I need to protect Donghae with my entire being. Wonho has been my bias since No Mercy. Like, he was my favorite member from episode one of No Mercy. Like, it's forever. It's forever. B2B, I've changed my bias like four times because I chose Sungjae from music videos, and then I switched to Peniel after Variety, and then I switched to Eunkwang after watching more Variety. So you should watch like at least something from your bias. I feel like it's so easy with all of the backstage like music show kind of variety shows that they do, or comeback week shows that they do, and weekly idol being a thing, and there's just so many little videos out there. I feel like you could just watch them. And then there's those people who make those compilation videos of just like funny moments with whatever, or you know, not that I watch those that often. I watched something the other day that was like an intro to UNB or something, because I was like, let's just learn a little bit more about the members, and it was hilarious. That's how I choose my biases, pretty straightforward. Some of my special like biases, like people I chose early on, 17, Aesculapes has been my bias since he was on Orange Caramel's album Lipstick, and he did that duet with Reina. I was like, whatever he debuts in, this boy's my bias. Like, I love that song. Madtown, I've changed biases too. It wasn't always Day One. It used to be Ho, and now it's Day One. Very much Day One. After Variety, because Day One doesn't have any lines in their debut music video. Golden Child, like I said, I had been following them for so long that I kind of was like, I mean, Haejun was supposed to be my bias, and then he left Woollim Entertainment because I like adored him. And I remember watching these pre-debut videos of Jungjoon and being like, he's so funny and he's so talented, like, love him a lot. Like, I was just, it was just kind of in a way that was like, I'm so excited for their debut, you know. And Seungyeon was in that MHDR thing with Hoya and Youngsoo. Daeil was in that too, but I decided a long time ago that I'm not allowed to bias Daeil because I bias Seungyeol, and that's just, one Yol is too many. That's too many for me. I can't handle more than one at a time. But yeah, Seungyeon had been in a little bit of a drama with Hoya and Myungsoo, and I thought he was so cute, and his voice was really, really good in that song. You can hear a little bit of it, but they kind of ended up being my biases after I watched Woollim pick, and I was like, I love them all, like I do with every single Woollim group when they debut. I'm like, I love every single member here, but I feel like Seungyeon and Jungjoon are my biases. Like, I just don't think anybody else can compare to them. So I end up double biasing, oh my gosh. But yeah, so that's it for how I choose my bias. Let me know how you choose your biases and what kind of bias you tend to gravitate towards down in the comment section down below. And I will see you guys very, very soon. Bye.